welcome to another Bristol Bears Community Foundation P and Sport session. Today we're going to be thinking about sensory sports and particularly sensory football. Many of you will have played with us sensory rugby or sensory basketball in the past, but now today we're going to be thinking about sensory football. The premise of the game is to recreate the experience of a football match through tactile objects and materials, through physical touch and through audio stimulus. Essentially, we're looking to bring young people with profound and multiple learning disabilities and sensory processing difficulties into a team sport and to really have fun and access football in a meaningful way to them as individuals, taking into account their varying needs. The structure of our sensory football is quite simple. Essentially, we've broken the game down into six key elements. And that allows us to understand what is involved in a football match and what it might feel like for the participants. So rather than just recreating skills or activities, we get to experience the whole game in a really immersive, sensory way. The whole structure of our sensory sport is based around audio tracks. A different audio track for each of the six key elements. We also start with a signature song and end with the same signature song to bookend the whole activity. Our football song to start so that we know it's time for football, and our football song to finish, the same track. Each track is roughly 3 minutes long and our intensive interaction is contained within those 3 minutes. That's a real chance to explore the concept of that part of the game and to really enjoy an interaction with the young person that we may be working with. In between each of those tracks is a critical period of silence. This is a chance to really process what has just happened to us, but also to begin to anticipate what might be coming next. What's the next part of the game? For some of our young people that have got high cognitive function but very limited physical ability, this is a real opportunity for them to make their own understanding of the game of football, to know what's coming next, to choose and think about their favourite bits, but also to really feel like they're progressing through the game, from the kickoff to passing to tackling all the way through to the end of the game, where they can feel like they've really played football. Our sensory sport comes in two different formats essentially, a static version and a dynamic version. The static is very much ground or floor based. It can be done in a chair or on a comfort or therapy bed also, but it's very stationary in its nature. The interaction happens in a fixed point. The alternative format, the dynamic sensory sport, is a step up, as it were, a progression, where we begin to move around either in our chairs or for ambulant participants be able to move around independently or with support, but it gives you a chance to explore space while still experiencing the same concepts of the sensory game itself. Today we're going to be looking at the static version of the game, our initial look at sensory sport, where we can all begin on a level playing field to experience the football together. You'll need a few simple objects to play sensory sports. You'll need football to start with. It can be any size ball, it doesn't have to be a football, but something round and that you can interact with in the same way you would a ball. And you'll also need a clapper. This is my homemade clapper. It's simply a piece of cardboard, folded several times, concertinaed in like a fan. Cardboard or card is very good for this. Give it a grip. You get a nice clapping noise or beating resonance off the body. Nice simple homemade cardboard clapper. Clapper and a football, you'll need those two things. It's really important that we take time to get ready for the session. So get comfortable out of your chairs, on the floor, on mats, on cushions. If you're staying in your chair, make sure you're in a comfortable position. Members of staff that are working with the young people, make sure you're comfortable too. It's important that you enjoy the experience also, and by being comfortable, you're in a much better position to support the young person in their game and in their fun as well. So if they're in a chair, make sure you've got a chair as well. You don't want to be standing up the whole time. It gives you a fixed point to return to and relax as well. As we said, the 60 seconds between are absolutely critical to allow a neutral sensory environment to really cleanse that sensory palate. So don't forget, staff and students, still quiet time between our interactions. Once you are comfortable, we can then begin to think about starting. Our signature song would kick in and we would go from there. So we're going to run through the pack now essentially together. I'll talk you through it, I'll give you some guidance, and then at each stage the music will kick in and your interaction will begin. But don't worry, we'll leave some notes on the screen so that you can follow those but have some fun by yourself with a young person. So now we're all sat comfortably, we're all ready to play. You can bring the lights down if it makes it more comfortable for yourselves, but just relax. Listening for our music. This is our key song. This is our signature song. It's our football song. It's time to play football.
I think it's bad news for the English game.
We're not creative enough, we're not positive enough.
It's coming home, it's coming home, it's coming, football's coming home.
We'll go on getting back, as I'm getting back, as I'm getting back, as I'm getting back.
It's coming, football's coming home, it's coming. So sure that England's gonna throw it away, gonna blow it away, but I know they can play, 'cause I remember three lads on a shirt, Jules Rimet still gleaming, 30 years of hurt never stopped me dreaming.
So many jokes, so many sneers, but all those also nears weigh you down through the years.
But I still see that tackle by Moore, and when Lineker scored, Bobby Belt in the ball,
and Nobby dancing.
Three lads on a shirt, Jules Rimet still gleaming, 30 years of hurt
Jules
remember, are 60 to 90 seconds of quiet, a processing time, a waiting time. Our game begins in the dressing room. This is where the tension and the preparation really begins, the anticipation building towards the match. It's where we get our whole body ready, we kit up, ready to go and play football. The dressing room is time to get the whole body ready. Starting with your fingers, is a firm gripping or massage of the fingers all the way down to the shoulders. We're going to progress from the shoulders down to the hips, from the hips all the way down to the toes, from your fingertips all the way down to your toes. Gentle or as firm as necessary. You know the young people best. You know what works for them. Massage down through the body. Feel the beat and the rhythm of the music. Let the music guide you as you get your body ready. It's time for the dressing room.
We'll be right back.
60 to 90 seconds, still, quiet, waiting. From the dressing room, we move out into the stadium, and it's the crowd. All the noise, the cheering, the fans, one voice together for one team. We're gonna feel the rhythm, feel the nature of that crowd. We're gonna need our hand clappers now. Don't have to use this, it could just be your hands on your body instead, but we're gonna begin to feel the beat and rhythm of the music. Model into the young person, perhaps. They can have a clapper of their own and clap along with you. Perhaps you're going to show them and they'll repeat the action. My turn, your turn. Similarly, it could just be you doing it on the body. Show them the clap, show them the beat, let them feel the beat. Again, let the music guide you, follow the beat of the music. Feel the intensity of the crowd, the atmosphere in the stadium. Here we go, it's the crowd.
Ole, 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 ole.
Ole, 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 ole.
The game's begun and we've got the ball and it's time to dribble. We're going to move and travel with that ball through the game. It's the dynamic, fluid nature of the ball moving with the body that we're looking to recreate. So the ball is going to be on the body. Remember, it's football, so we're using the lower half of the body particularly. So rolling that ball in a gentle motion down through the leg towards the foot. It can be a slow motion, but keep it a fluid, smooth motion. Just like a dribbler would be on the pitch. Think Diego Maradona, think Lionel Messi. The fluid, smooth nature of the ball. Rolling down towards the foot, pushing the ball against the foot to feel the pressure. Pressure and release, like kicking a ball. Pressure, feeling the ball on the foot, the pressure, and then releasing it away. If appropriate for the young person you're working with, hold the ball there and encourage a kick. Push it off, or encourage an independent kick from the young person. If you do get a reaction, however big or small, make sure you celebrate it. That's them playing football. Smooth and fluid, exploring that ball with your legs and with your feet. Here's the ball, it's time to dribble. We'll be right back. remember within the game there are two teams and the other team are really going to come into it now with the tackle. The concept here is the physical contact between the two, that competition for the ball. The other team trying to take it off you, the physical battle between the two. For within our activity, we're going to be looking at the shoulder and hip areas, particularly where the contact will be made in a football match. So we're going to start with a gentle massage of the shoulders or of the hip area if appropriate and if our positioning allows as well. Feeling those key contact areas that we would feel within the tackle. It could be a roll or a push on those areas. You know the young person. Go with what works for you both. We can progress from there also to you sitting or lying beside them and feeling that shoulder to shoulder and hip to hip contact. Start to nudge them and bump them as gentle or as vigorous as they enjoy. Be safe, but get physical. It's a good excuse to do so. Are you ready? It's the tackle!
Introduce you please to a lump of cheddar cheese. Knit one, pow one, drop one, cow one.
Yeah!
big end to the game. It's the penalty shootout. The tension, the pressure, the anticipation of the build-up to the penalty kick, taking the kick, and obviously what the result of that kick may mean. We've all been there. The penalty shootout. Similar to our dribbling is focusing on the contact of the ball with the leg. Moving down the leg, feel free to start from the knee rather than the hip, if our processing allows that to create that physical pathway. But the real focus here is on the foot and the release. Lots of pressure on the foot. Hold that pressure, allow the pressure to build with the ball, and then release the ball away. The hit of the kick is what we're looking to recreate. Feeling the ball, making contact, and the release, the sudden release as we hit that ball towards the net for the penalty. Again, encourage lots of independent kicking as appropriate, but encourage them to wait, hold it, kick, just like the referee's whistle. As we get ready for the penalty shootout.
Thank you.
we're coming to the end of our game now. It's time to think about the team, your team, everyone coming together at the end of the game. One badge, one colour, one team. We're going to reflect that through some physical interaction, some handshaking. Could be a gripped or firm massage instead of a handshake. Forearms, arms, shoulders, patting on the back. Lots of positive reflective language as well, celebrating the game, celebrating the input also. Could begin to then move to sit next to the young person or to bring young people next to each other if appropriate. Linking arms. Arms round the shoulder or the waist as appropriate, bringing people together. Could just be the visual nature of seeing you sat with the young person and other pairs around the room. It's togetherness, it's being one team. Your team.
Well, some of the crowd are on the pitch. Well, some of the crowd are on the pitch. They think it's all over, but it is now.
Take him on, you never give up, it's one.
has quiet time to finish, just waiting. A game has finished, but just waiting. Our game has come to an end. We will finish with the same song as we started with. Remember, it's really important to not start to move or prepare to leave until this song finishes as well. This is our end song, our closing song. The same as we started, our football song. Just relax. It's a quiet time, a processing and reflective time of what has happened today. Remembering our experience of playing football. Just take the time and relax. Football has finished. It's our football song.
I think it's bad news for the English game.
We're not creative enough, and we're not positive enough.
It's coming home, it's coming home, it's coming.
We'll go on getting back, as I'm getting back, as I'm getting back, as I'm getting back.
It's coming, football's coming home. It's coming. So sure that England's gonna throw it away, gonna blow it away, but I know they can play, 'cause I remember three lines on a shirt. Jewels remain still gleaming, 30 years of hurt never stop me dreaming.
So many jokes, so
see that tackle by Moore, and when Lineker scored, Bobby Belt in the ball,
and Nobby dancing.
Three lines on a shirt, jewels remain still gleaming. 30 years of hurt never stop me dreaming.
It's coming home, it's coming home, it's coming, football's coming.
finished. Take time to recreate this several times within a week to create a consistent pattern of understanding and anticipation, or take time each week in the same environment, the same circumstances, ideally the same day and time as well, to play in consecutive weeks to build up a sense of anticipation, a sense of recall around what comes next and what might have happened to us the last time. We can also begin to measure the small steps of participation or reaction across those weeks, across those multiple sessions. Remember, there is no right or wrong way to do this. This is just guidance. If you find something that works with the young person you're working with that's more beneficial, then go with it. If it gets a reaction and gets a response, particularly a positive one, then stick with that instead. You know the young people best, and they know themselves very well. The important thing is that everyone comes together, and regardless of our needs, we all get to join in with a meaningful game of football. Hope you've enjoyed your game today. Look forward to seeing you for another game. Thanks.